fracturing there. Do you have a little slice of throat?
You'd better hurry. We're getting into San Francisco in 5 minutes. Asta, my best Sunday go-to-meeting hat.
Dolly, don't you want to pack this?
How they can expect a woman to still have any mystery left for a man after living in a place like this for 3 days, I don't know.
Darling, you don't need mystery. You've got something much better, something more alluring.
What?
Me.
You. It's all right. We're married. Dear, will you pack this?
Yes.
I only took that to please my wife. She wanted some excitement.
Well, I guess she had it.
Oh, it was wonderful. Two men tried to kill him. But he's not going to take any more cases. You can print that.
That's my darling.
Here's another one of those call Long Island operator number 15. Don't you think you ought to call her?
Certainly not. She knows better than that. I told her I was bringing the wife on this time.
I don't know why I always take it for granted that you're kidding.
Is my sister up?
Yes, Miss Margaret. She was feeling a little splunklish this morning, but I got her up.
Next time she tells you she feels splunklish, you tell her not to be a clunk.
Thanks, Your Honor.
I dig you. Did you sleep well?
Oh, splunklish. Don't be a clunk, Miss Susan.
You've been coaching her.
Someone has to protect her.
Hello, Anne. Hello, Mother. Hello, Ernestine.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Frank.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Martha.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Bill.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Lillian.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Fred.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Dan.
Hello, Mother.
Hello, Jack.
Anything else?
Sure. Cognac, absinthe, and a dash of bitters.
Oh, Amy, you'll kill my guests. No, these are respectable people.
Marriage has changed you a lot, Evelyn. You used to have plenty of zip and bounce, and now you're so old, so good and bounceless. Does your husband beat you?
No, I wish he did. He'd have to come home to do it.
That's funny. That wasn't here when I came in.
Maybe some man just put it there.
Oh, I don't think so. It would have to be a man who knew exactly what I wanted.
Really?
Oh, darling, I've always wanted a photo.
That's the best I could rent for 35 cents a day.
It's pretty cheap, considering it has my initials on it.
Now, let's see, where was I? Oh, yes, I know. I was right there.
Every time you mess up my lip, Bruce, it takes me 10 minutes longer to get ready.
I'll take a half hour's worth of that.
Stop it, stop it. I'm a married woman. I'll tell my husband. I'll tell him when he comes in.
Darling, I got some great news for you.
What?
I've decided to keep you another year.
Maybe you haven't seen the other models. They haven't got brakes like me.
Last year, you nearly upset the boat.
You nearly upset the boat, you beast. And you weren't stargazing when you did it.
Oh, it's you.
I think so. After that rousing welcome, may I come in?
To say nothing of the possibility of a free meal.
Children should be seen and not heard, Meg.
I'll give you 10 to 1 we have to pay his fare home.
You nasty child. She must take after her father.
They're such great pals. He's getting more like his father every day.
He sure is. This morning he's playing with a corkscrew.
The darling. He's reading the baby fairy tales.
Foxy Gent, who stops in the stretch. Hasn't a chance to win. But he's liable to come in first in case he forgets to quit.
Nick, why don't you just put down a book and read the racing form?
Nicholas, you know you're getting more like your mother every day.
What cultured tomatoes. Hey, get a load of that one. Yoo-hoo.
Boys, boys, in polite society, we don't say yoo-hoo. We say yoo-hoo.
Nick, hi.
Hi.
You remember Mrs. Charles?
Hi. Hi.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Junior, Hey, how is the little squirt?
The little squirt is fine. And thanks to your teaching, he can crack any safe in town now in 15 minutes.
I love it. Just the pure, natural juice of the apple. What could be better, for instance?
A dry martini, for instance.
That horrible stuff almost took the lining off my stomach.
Why do you care? It didn't show.
Good gracious.
Why, how
what's the matter?
Mickey!
Blockbuster.
No.
Oh. Nope. Just... Oopsie-daisy. You just wait a couple of weeks on this cider and I'll be a new man.
Well, I sort of like the old one.
Why, darling, that's the nicest thing you said to me since the time I got my head caught in that cuspidor at the Waldorf.
Well, that wasn't the Waldorf. That was the Astor.
Astor?
Astor.
All animals must go in the baggage car.
No, that's not an animal. That's my fur coat.
If it can wag its tail, it goes in the baggage car.
So it was going to be a cinch, hey? Very well.
Credit me with an error.
I don't understand it myself sometimes. But there I was, alone, in Rio, in April.
Very romantic.
Madly romantic. It was raining. Spring rain, turning the pavements blue. I adore rain.
I detest it. It gives me head colds. And furthermore, if it was so romantic, why did you leave him?
It stopped raining. You'd better be very apologetic this morning, my dear Mr. Winkle.
What's the matter?
You're in the doghouse with me today, Gussie.
I am? Why?
This last letter from my wandering husband. If you're going to go on writing these Valentines for me, you better be more careful.
What's wrong with it?
Oh, nothing. Only he's supposed to be in South America, and in the corner of the envelope, there's a little note which reads, Schulz's Butcher Shop, West 9th Street. Bring home pot roast for Emily.
Well,
Yes, check over those proofs. I'll be in and look at them in a minute.
Who do you think this is?
Simpson.
No. Try again.
Finney?
No. Try again.
Oh, I give up.
Surprise?
A husband.
Yes.
Oh, nice. Nick, look. My purse is gone.
Darling, isn't that too bad? Nora, I want you to know Fingers. How this is my wife.
Your wife?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know you were married.
Oh, yes, I'm married.
Nick, what do? I know I had it.
Oh, don't worry, darling. It'll turn up, won't it, Fingers?
Well, I certainly hope so.
Yeah.
Well, Nick, am I tickled to death to see you.
Yeah.
Good old Nick. And married, too. I didn't know you were married.
Oh, yes.
Well, I'm glad I bumped into you. Well, goodbye, Mrs. Charles.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Fingers. Come on, dear.
Well, darling, I can't just go off.
Come on, we don't want to embarrass him.
What are you talking about?
He's a purse snatcher. Think of his feelings.
Well, then he must have taken it.
So long, Fingers.
So long, Nick.
There you are, dear.
Dear, you do know the nicest people. Oh, hello, Nora. Oh, hello.
Who's that?
Oh, you wouldn't know them, Dolly. They're respectable.
Ik vond het aangenaam u te ontmoeten.
Nice to have met you. For heaven's sake, Dutch Embassy. I'll never get used to this hand kissing.
You will. My complaint is they never kiss a single woman.
Get married, girl. My, he was pretty. Nice to have met you.
Italian Embassy.
Wasn't that Dutchman homely?
Don't look now. One just came in that's really ridiculous. I'll tell you when to look up. He's passing by. I don't like a man that handsome.
How are you, darling?
Mrs. Cartwright, may I present my fiancé, Prince Nicholas of Belsky?
How do you do?
How do you do?
I'm very happy to have met you.
It was nice meeting you. You understand when I said I didn't like a man that handsome, it was only a generality.
It's all right. He's the closest person I know to my father.
Madame désire-t-elle prendre autre chose?
Put your hand back. He's the waiter. Oh, for heaven's sakes.